Detroit City, led by Trevor James in his second season, trying to get this club back on track. Had a great start a year ago. This year has not been quite the same. There is the whistle blows, and here we go from Sacramento. It's the Republic and Les Rouges in week number 7, the USL Championship. Sacramento, the black kits, and it's the mint shorts and white tops for Detroit City FC. What do you expect for the first 10 minutes here? What will we see from Detroit City? And will they be aggressive? Will they sit back? What do you think?
Well, we had an opportunity to talk to Coach Mark Briggs ahead of this game, and he mentioned that every team that's come to play against Sac Republic here at Heart Health Park has tried to go toe-to-toe with them to try to play, and that hasn't worked out for any of the teams that have stepped foot here at the stadium. But he expects Detroit City, who have been very stout defensively themselves, to maybe sit back, park the bus, I think is the familiar phrase. But he's put a whole bunch of numbers behind the ball, and that'll be an opponent that Sac hasn't really seen just yet. How are they going to break down that low block? So it'll be a good test for these guys in black tonight.
Shane Wheat getting ahead to it. Shane Wheat in that left center back position, coming over from Pittsburgh a year ago, led the club in tackles, and he has not missed a beat here. Lee Desmond still out on injury, working his way back. But Shane Wheat, Jared Timmer, Connor Donovan all making a strong case to Mark Briggs that those three should be kept in the lineup for the time being. Here's Kecko getting the start. Sebastian Herrera is back in the 18 after a couple weeks off from a hamstring injury. We may see him later in the game, depending on how this one plays out.
I actually like that early long ball there from Kecko, because I think it sends a message to Detroit City that they're looking for it, right? The Cicerone is looking to get in behind, and ultimately, you keep looking for that. Maybe one time it's on, but if it's not, it opens up space in front of that back four. So we're kind of curious to see what Kecko does in his decision-making moving forward.
Jalen Robinson on this right side, MLS experience with DC United, USL, Pittsburgh, Phoenix, Richmond as well. Quick tap here. They're going to try to spring Connor Rutz forward a little bit. We've seen some opportunities. Look at Richard Ballard, though, playing higher. Rutz had a really nice strike in that 3-1 victory over El Paso, the only victory for Detroit City this year. Win as an own goal as it bounced off of Yuma. But nonetheless, those are the type of goals you just hate as a striker, because you did everything right, and unfortunately, you don't get the score. Book
yeah.
to go with you.
No doubt.
Here's Kecko inside. Takes a deflection working here. Sanchez! It may have taken a bit of a deflection, but Roro will get to it and keep it in possession for Sacramento.
Yeah, one of the things I've loved about the Republic so far this season is their desire to get forward. Anytime there's a ball that goes out wide, you can see 3, 4, 5 guys get into the box. That's the confidence that I was talking about before the game kicked off. When you know that you're so stout defensively, you're not going to make too many mistakes on that side of the ball, you're willing to take those risks to get into the box. And so the Republic need to do more of that, because it's putting a lot of teams under pressure.
Republic off to a 4-0-2 start, unbeaten through 6, also winning the Open Cup 5-4. And you just look at how many goals, 14 goals scored in the last 4 matches.
That's pretty good, right?
Overall,
I was a math major, but I didn't graduate, Rob.
And 0 scores. Goals allowed here in USL play, just 1 coming back. That was way back in Charleston Battery here back in week 2, and that was when the Republic were even down a man for a certain point of time. So defensively, obviously, as a defense guy, I know you love this, and the units working together, easier said than done to keep teams scoreless the way they have, especially the teams that Republic had faced early on.
Yeah, no question. Then, of course, you need your goalkeeper to step up and make some saves, which he's done with some real class. That timely save is really important.
Gurr sending this cross in, and Nate Steinwasher is able to get there right before Alder Sanchez. But how active Jack Gurr has been this year. Mark Briggs challenging Jack in the offseason to get him more in the attack. He wants to see more goals, more assists. Last year, just 1 goal, 3 assists. This year, already 2 goals and 2 assists, along with 11 chances created. That's another one right there. He has just been a top performer, really one of the best in all of USL from that right side.
No question, and I think his combination play, I think that Roro's done a nice job too of finding him and getting him involved, so that when Jack Gurr makes that pass in the midfield, he can run with purpose. Sometimes you see players, they make the pass and they don't know if they're going to get it back. So do they want to make that commitment and run 30, 40 yards with a 50% maybe getting that ball back, knowing that if you lose it, you're going to have to track another 40, 50 yards to go back? But I think with the way that they're set up under Mark Briggs, they've done a really nice job of bringing both of their wing backs into it. But I think Jack Gurr has really, really excelled on the right side this season.
Detroit here looking for an opportunity. Bring it down. Here's Ben Morris to his left foot. Able to get around, sneaking through. And again, Arnold Lopez, time and time again this season, has just been a cog in that defensive wheel and stopping momentum, preventing balls from being crossed in and getting good looks for the opponent.
Yeah, I'd probably go out on a limb and say, and maybe you agree with me, Rob, that Arnold Lopez is probably the real MVP of this whole thing, the unsung hero, doing a lot of the dirty work, protecting that back three, allowing Felipe Lopez, or Luis Felipe, excuse me, in general, to go forward and be a little bit more box to box. So it's been impressive from him, and just that discipline to stay in that spot.
Connor Donovan battling a little bit of chance there taken to send that ball out. Our referee is Jeremy Shear tonight. And as a defender, how much did you love a midfielder who was just gritty and able to really make an impact on the game night after night?
Oh, yeah, I play with that player all day, every day. There's no question.
Luis Felipe finding Kecko. Republic looking to build here. Lopez giving all kinds of freedom just to work through the circle.
I think that just shows you what Detroit City wants to do or who they're allowing to have the ball.
Jacker to the corner. Kecko, a little overstep, but gets there with his left foot. Over the top, and it's Michael Bryant, who has been critical to the team's success. The captain out of Portola Hills, California, has been a key member of that back line for Detroit City and Trevor James' side, and does this team a service there by sending it away. But it's the Atlas disposal, first corner kick of the game, and Rodrigo Lopez, of course, will take this. Leads the team in chances created with 18, also the USL Championship. And of course, a legend here in Sacramento, looking to get Republic on the board with a set piece. Donovan, and it just skirts off to the right side. He knew he had a golden opportunity there.
Oh, that was a tantalizing set piece there from Rodrigo Lopez. Really, really good service. I would be salivating at that opportunity. I scored a couple headers back in my day, and I think that Connor Donovan probably want that one back. But I want to give a shout out to Nate Stainwatcher. I mean, he's been unbelievable in goal, arguably one of the most impressive players in all of USL, just making so many big saves to keep Detroit City in a lot of their games.
Just 4 points on the year, 1-4-1, a -2 goal differential. And we talked about it in the pregame, haven't scored in more than a month now. Confidence wise, what does that do to a team? And builds a lot of pressure in trying to put in the back of the net.
No, I'm glad you brought that up, because if you're a team that doesn't score a lot, that puts a lot of tension on your group overall. Everybody has to be perfect. The defense has to be perfect. Nate Stainwatcher and goal has to be perfect. And that starts to build up. And only a goal can release that type of pressure. So for them, I think they're trying to probably get the game 0-0 at halftime. If they can steal a goal, they'll take it, of course. But then maybe in the second half, they'll start to open up and look for those opportunities. But right now, it just seems like they're just trying to absorb the possession and the pressure that Sacramento's putting on them.
Rodriguez battling here in the midfield, and it's Lopez able to come away with it. And here's Alder Sanchez, a 20-year-old, joined as a trialist, given an opportunity, and he has made the best of it and getting the start tonight, his first on the year. Kecko turning, plays into the corner. Gurr whipping this ball in. Chance for Cicerone. Here's Luis Felipe. Crowd wanting it. And it's Gurr's through! What a goal, Luis Felipe! Number 4 on the year. They keep coming. They keep making runs. And good things keep happening to the Sacramento Republic. They're up a goal here in the 9th minute.
Oh, injected straight into my veins. Luis Felipe. Unbelievable. I feel like I've seen this before.
Over and over again.
Luis Felipe making a back post run, joining the attack late from across, from out wide, from Jack Gurr, and it leads to an early goal in the first half for the Sac Republic. A fantastic finish. They've been doing this over and over and over, and they've been doing it consistently. And you have to think that Trevor James, the coach of Detroit City, knows that this is coming. The players are prepared for this, and yet they can't stop it. It really speaks to the quality of Sac Republic and just the numbers they get into the box here. Good heads up play by Cicerone, but Luis Felipe, hey, you never score if you don't shoot. He finds himself in a good spot. He's got a ton of confidence, like we said at the top of the game. And now they've got that 1-0 lead. It's going to be very difficult for Detroit City to find their way back into this.
We see a lot of teams and individuals make great efforts. I don't know if we've seen a Republic team in 10 years have this many team-like goals than what we're seeing here in 2023.
Yeah, and I think that should make everybody happy that supports this club. And the fact that you are missing a couple players that could maybe help make this even better, but it doesn't matter. You've created an identity. And I think what happens is when a coach establishes an identity of how we want to play and the players go out and execute that identity at a high level, then the buy-in from the players just continues to grow and grow and grow. And I think that's what we're seeing here with the Sac Republic this
season.
Turn
over here. Ballard looking for an opportunity. Out wide it comes, and just a misstruck ball coming in from the left side. Ben Morris misses a golden opportunity to get his first goal on the year.
Really unacceptable, I think, for Ben Morris. This is a player that has a lot of quality, came through the Ipswich Town Youth Academy. He's been around, he's seen some things. As I mentioned in the pregame show, he's been on the youth national teams for England. He just needs to take a touch here, but you gotta respect Detroit City's pressure. I really like what they're doing here. Good pass there from Rich Ballard, and that just has to be on frame. You have to make the goalkeeper make a save in that situation.
Meanwhile, Sacramento running again. Here comes Lopez into the 18. He's gonna serve this ball in, and it's gonna go off the head of Jalen Robinson. Our inactive report brought to you by Delta Dental. Lee Desmond is out, Dami Villadere, as well as Stephen Carroll and Matt Lewis are out for Detroit City FC. And here's another corner kick opportunity for Sacramento. Mark Briggs wants to see more goals, more good looks come off of these set pieces for the Republic here. Just two set piece goals in 2023. Rodrigo Lopez. Jack Gurr crosses this ball instead. Here comes Shane Weeden flying through the air. And Steinwasher may have just been able to bump Shane Wheat just enough off a frame there, but Sacramento almost scoring the second goal in the 12th minute.
Yeah, and guess who was involved again? Rodrigo Lopez and Jack Gurr. Obviously, one's off a set piece, but the team does a very good job of, hey, if it's tight in the middle, we're going to get the ball out wide. And Jack Gurr has been timing his runs to perfection, and then he whips in a great, dangerous ball, which unfortunately Wheat didn't get his head on, but it was a good look there. And here we take another look at how this all unfolds. But Jack Gurr's in a good spot, ready to play it back into the mixer, as they say, and just a little off from making this one 2-0. Steinwasher, I think, does enough to maybe put him off, gets a little bit of a nudge when he goes up. Always gonna be a bit of a tough header there, but I appreciate his bravery.
You know, if he came down awkwardly or ran to one of his own players, but yeah, that would be a big loss here if they have to go make a change in one of the goalkeeper positions. And you look at some of the hard times this Detroit team has already fallen on this year. I mean, this is a team we talked about, haven't scored in 35 days, and they just haven't been able to put the ball in the back of the net. And compared to last year, where they really started hot, and as Republic played them early on in June, they were undefeated. They hadn't been beaten, and they were one of the best teams in the Eastern Conference, and it slipped a little bit toward the end. But this year has been much different. It looks like Steinwasher will be okay. But if you're Trevor James, you don't have a big roster. You've got some key guys. You lost some big names like Antoine Hopeno was one of the players gone. Declan Wynn, Pato, another guy. And that was 18 goals and 19 assists, no longer on this team.
Yeah, Hopeno is, I think, the one that hurts them the most because he led the league in assists last year. He had 11. That's not easy to replicate. But then when you bring in these different players, Ben Morris is a great example. He has an unbelievable chance to equalize and get this game back to 1-1. That's why you brought him in. That's why he has that experience. And then for him to not even make Sacramento suffer in that situation, I think really kind of speaks to where Detroit City is at this very moment. I'm a big fan of Trevor James. I think he's a fantastic manager. I love the fans. Shout out to all the Detroit City fans that are out there watching this one. And I think this team will end up making the playoffs. I just think they've had so much turnover. They've had some injury. They've had guys that are not in form. They just haven't really locked in their identity for right now. But they've got plenty of time to change that.
Deep into the corner for Gurr. And, you know, talking to the guys last year, one of their favorite places on the road was playing Detroit. It's a hostile environment. Fans are right on top. I mean, it was an unbelievable experience. Obviously, the win was great. They win 2-0. But they felt that there was a great fan base, and they really enjoyed playing there. They don't say that for every road team, let's put it that way.
No, it's definitely one of my bucket list items is to get out to Detroit to catch a DCFC game. And I hope I get to do that very, very soon. And hopefully it's in a better way. I know that I wish I could go on Tuesday when they play Minnesota United in the U.S. Open Cup after what they did last year, taking down the Columbus Crew. It'd be very cool to see them take another MLS scalp, but we'll end up seeing if they can do it or not.
Yeah, right. Columbus Crew 2-1. They advanced the round of 32. Unfortunately, would lose to Lewis City, but another chance to make some history against Minnesota United later this week. Sacramento will take on the Oakland Roots. And registration for Republic FC summer camps and clinics now available in addition to lifelong memories. Each camp will take home a ticket to an upcoming match and ball. For more information, visit sacrepublicfc.com, camps and clinics. Detroit 1-2-1 on the road this year. Republic unbeaten with 3 wins and a draw. And Les Rouges find themselves down a goal off of Luis Felipe, an assist from Russell Cicerone, his third assist on the campaign. Into the corner it goes, and good defending again by Jack Gerg.
Yeah, we see a good look right now at Sac Republic. Got a line of five, line of six there in the back line. I mean, that's why this commitment to get back behind the ball, to be difficult to break down, is the reason that they've only given up one goal this season. Obviously, we could argue that some of these other teams haven't taken their chances, and that's all part of it. And this is going to crumble at some point. I think the big key for me when I watch any teams is when things aren't going well, how quickly can you regain your composure, whether it's in game or during a full season? If you lose one, does that turn into three losses? Or if you lose one, you're just going to be right back at it and winning again, right? That's really the sign of a team or any kind of team or mentality that they have. And I think Sac Republic just have so much confidence they can play through any situation. Detroit City, I'm not so sure, but we got plenty of time to see if they can or not.
Well, Detroit City may be employing more of a high press now after going down a goal. Maxi Rodriguez, one goal on the year. And Yazid Matthews, who's on the bench, leads the team with 2 goals, one in Open Cup and one against El Paso. He's trying to find some answers up top. Meanwhile, good possession here, trying to break through. Simonson working along that touchline. Aldair Sanchez, a 20-year-old. He is a tough player. They love his grittiness. They love his service ability. And he has been quite impressive and filled in for Domi Villadere, who scored the first goal against Detroit City in the win last year. Then Kecko added another in the second half.
Yeah, I love his backstory. I love everything about it. The fact that you have a system that can identify diamonds in the rough, and then for him to get that opportunity to play and prove himself is fantastic.
Kecko tried to find Cicerone. Would have been offside anyway. It's probably going to work out a little bit better. Going to find Gerr. Go on the right side. Coming through is Rodrigo Lopez, and just not the right angle, and it's able to get to Nate Steinwasher. It breaks up what it could have been another goal-scoring opportunity for Sacramento. Meanwhile, the counter coming for Detroit. Good, dangerous ball, and this one's cross red. Vidiello's going to come out for it as Ballard able to get to it instead. Vidiello's going to backpedal. Detroit showing some life here early. Ballard. And stays in play. Detroit still. Republic have relaxed just a bit. Could be dangerous. This one coming through. And it'll be a throw.
This is worth the price of admission, Rob. This has been end to end, and I am absolutely here for it. Good sequence there, too, from Sac Republic to get into a good spot. Jack Gerr once again just timing his run to perfection. I'm sure he's going to want that cross back, but just so dangerous in transition. And we talked to Mark Briggs a couple days ago, and he said, because we asked him point blank, what do you have to work on? You're awesome going forward. You're great defensively. What is there to work on? He said, we fine tune. We can be cleaner in transition. We can be better on set pieces. We can be more ruthless. And they're showing elements of that tonight. But in that transition, we saw one there. Jacker just got to have a little bit more quality in that cross. But then, of course, there is some vulnerability. When you start to commit numbers going forward, if Detroit City got a little bit cleaner on their end, it could have been 1-1, but it's still 1-0.
The mentality this year, it's kind of the three H's, hungry, humble, and horrible. And being a bit horrible means on the field, humble off of the field. But the hunger part, I think they've shown that they're willing to work for it. I think what Mark wants is that nastiness that they've shown a bit, but that technical finish is also maybe a part of that. Just being horrible to play against him. I mean, he thinks some of these games, 4-0, 5-0 wins, could have been even more. Coaches are never happy, right?
No, they're never happy. You can't be satisfied for sure. But I think in that last sequence where Jack didn't hit a great cross, that's going to be one of those moments where Mark says, hey, we got to kill the game off. We have an opportunity to put this game to bed. And they've done a good job in the last two home games, scoring 3 goals in the first half.
Morris angling in. We'll send this ball low. Jared Timmer will clear it away. Well, it's $5 beer night at Heart Health Park on April 26th as Oakland Roots come to town for the third round of the U.S. Open Cup kickoff at 7 o'clock. Tickets are starting at just $14. course, the incredible run. You were here for the match against Sporting KC, your former MLS club. And what a night that was. And so we appreciate it was a Jimmy Conrad 1-0 record so far, trying to make it 2-0. Is your opportunity?
I picked a great time. Sac Republic's playing great. Detroit City's still trying to figure things out, but I'm liking what I'm seeing from Detroit now. You almost wish, and I'm sure Trevor James, their manager, thinks the same thing. Why didn't we just start the game this way? They sat back a little bit. Now they're playing on the front foot, asking questions of Sac Republic, and getting corners, getting crosses, poking around. This is the type of intensity they're going to need to get back into this game. Right now, I think the Sac Republic's dropped off maybe a little bit too much. Nothing too threatening, but, you know, the more you allow that to happen, the more better chances are going to be created, and that's where it starts to get real dangerous.
It will be a goal kick as Aldair Sanchez and Maxi Rodriguez, a little shoulder to shoulder. Well, choosing the right health plan for you and your family is simple. With Western Health Advantage, check out Affordable Weight Plans. They have been helping our community strong for over 25 years. Go online to westernhealth.com. Danny Vidiello, 4-0-2 as a starter, 5 shutouts, 16 saves. And of course, just the 1 goal allowed against Charleston Battery back in week 2 here at home.
That ball from Arnold Lopez is unbelievable because it unlocks all the pressure that Detroit City is trying to have. And now they can really get at him on the front foot. Anytime that you have Roro Lopez on the ball and he can look up is always a good thing. It didn't work out in this one, but it's just a sign of intent and the quality that Sac Republic possess. I mean, we talk about some of these other attacking players, but when Arnold Lopez is whipping 60-yard balls to switch the point of attack to get out of some pressure, you got some quality on this team that you should be proud of, all you Sac Republic fans.
Especially as you're holding midfielder, defensive guy, looking to just muck up the game a little bit, and he serves ball like that, springing guys forward. And again, Sebastian Herrera, number 1, number 9 on this team, he is on the bench tonight, back from injury, but will he see action? Maybe not. Maybe they get him a little run, but they'd probably like to save him for Wednesday if possible against Oakland. And a misstruck there ball by Steinwasher, and then the ensuing throw leads to a little bit of a push from Maxi Rodriguez, and now a set piece and really good veteran play by Rodrigo Lopez to set up this, Jimmy.
He's a crafty veteran, 35-year-old, doing his thing. He's been around, he's seen some things, and got himself a nice free kick in a dangerous area. We'll see. This is what Mark Briggs wanted to see. Can they execute on set pieces?
Steinwasher double punch away, and the foul on Cicerone coming in inside the 6. They'll set up a goal kick for Detroit City FC, and like most strikers, they can't believe they committed a foul.
Yeah, I don't have time for a lot of strikers, to be honest, as a former center back. But I get what he's saying, that when you go up for a ball and the goalkeeper jumps into you, what are you supposed to do? You're just playing the ball. But there does seem to be an unspoken rule that the goalkeepers get overly protected by the referees. And it's just part of the game. So
we saw that
Russell
a lot.
Will get over it.
We saw that a lot last year, where it was almost too much in favor one way or the other, and almost like protecting the quarterback in football. And it can be difficult for strikers. And for many of those who are even another defender coming inside the boxes, Keiko is brought down. Will we see a booking beyond that? I don't think it's enough from Amang Muntsa, but it's at least a warning, and you can see it there from Jeremy Shear saying no more of that to the 26-year-old.
Yeah, I'm excited to see Devin Amumensa back into the team, his first minutes of the season after tearing his ACL. I think that shows a little bit of rust. He seems just in a hurry to make that play. Okay, Keiko gets to it first, no big deal. Just usher him towards the sideline. Wait for some help there, and it just felt like he lacked a little patience. But he's going to get sharper as the season goes along, and I think he's a great player. I'm excited to see how he continues to perform after this injury.
The captain, Rodrigo Lopez, one more time on a set piece. Ball driven up. Here comes Shane Wheat over the crossbar. That's twice tonight, though. The Akron, Ohio native coming in. Most active we've really seen him on set pieces. You got to probably think, you know, if you're going to start to nitpick at things, probably want some goals from your back line this year, right?
Well, that would help, of course. Anytime that some of the defenders can chip in on the offensive side, it's great. He's going to want that one back. Just mistimed his jump slightly. Maybe he thought he was going to get a nudge, but that's a pretty clean look. And I know that Coach Briggs is going to be pretty disappointed that they're not getting that second goal to really put this game out of reach.
Keiko, a little bit of a display himself. Here's Simonsen working through the center of the park. And again, Jared Timmer, time and time again this year, have just made the small play that has just been so impactful. Bryant trying to get to it, gets ahead to it, misdirects it. Keiko was the intended target here. And again, the center back is come in and played in different roles. He's a midfielder really by initial trade, but it was moved to center back because of the injuries this club suffered and has pretty much held that as a starting role coming in 2023. Well, there's a missed opportunity, unfortunately, for Detroit City. Slows it up, but they'll get it back. Crystal Creamery has been building strong bones and bodies with the freshest dairy from the Central Valley since 1901. Taking pride in delivering dairy you can trust. Grab a glass and taste how fresh local can be. Simple, local, fresh.
I think it's interesting when you change positions because of a necessity of your team due to injury, suspension, whatever it is. If I had to move, and I was traditionally in midfield and had to move to the back line, I just wouldn't complicate the game. I would make everything simple. And I think that kind of speaks to the ethos of what Mark Briggs wants from his team, especially that back line. Don't be anything that you're not. Just play what you see. We already have enough playmakers. Just get the ball to those guys. Be stout defensively, be hard to play against, be organized, talk, and we're going to be in a good spot. And that's what we're seeing. And that execution from every line of the field from Sac Republic has been immense this season.
Sanchez, a nice job to get it off McCabe, and will earn a throw. Republic number one in the power rankings. Meanwhile, Detroit at the very bottom, unfortunately, at number 24. But 10th in the Eastern Conference, still has plenty of time to move up, get into that playoff picture. They did add O'Neill Fisher,
the Jamaican international,
MLS experience, and that may mean that some of the guys who are on the back line moving up in the midfield and gives them another option, and a guy who's obviously proven he could play just about anywhere and have an impact.
Yeah, we're seeing another, for me, emotional foul from Detroit City. This is a lack of composure, I would say, that they're getting frustrated. And sure, okay, maybe Cicerone's making a meal of it, whatever it may be, but the calls aren't going your way, and it feels like at times when you're seeing one of your leaders in your team start to get frustrated, that starts to trickle around everybody else, and then you start to lose your composure as a group collectively, and it's just a lot harder to get back into the game when you're getting overly emotional. You're losing that control that you need to have, I think, to see it out, to get that result over 90 minutes.
If you're wondering who's that voice, it's not Adam Moffitt. The accent is gone, and it's Jimmy Conrad. And thanks for joining us. We're so thrilled you're here on the broadcast, as now Detroit's looking to make a little bit moves of their own. Unfortunately, the referee involved again, and Timmer goes back. And it's a little bit all around the pitch here.
Silky.
Nicely done. And look at this. Playing it right into the bucket in front of Keiko. Making a run. Sanchez in support. Keiko just trying to find a space. And too much of LaRouge was able to get back here on that possession. And a hard challenge. As Wheat stood his ground and Bryant went right into him. And with that pause, it allows us to hear a word from our sponsor at SMUD.
With SMUD rebates, you'll save big. Save money and save the planet for generations to come. Get rebates up to $3,500 from SMUD on clean power appliances, electric vehicles, and much more at cleanpowercity.org.
So the plus 11 goal differential is the best mark in club history through six league games for Sacramento Republic. Sanchez taking advantage.
Just the body language there from Simonsen. He lays it off to Ballard. Ballard's not ready for it. He gets emotional, right? It's starting to see that ripple effect that I'm talking about, where things just aren't going their way. They had an opportunity to potentially get something going, somebody bobbles it, and now it's a transition the other way like we're seeing right now.
Sanchez played into some space and just a bit mishit. Morris again attacking just outside the 18, and Timmer able to make a nice defensive play. And I know as a defensive guy, you love that hustle and effort by Jared Timmer.
Oh, I love that. Reminds me of me back in the day, Rob. I absolutely love there. You have to find your way in. You thought you did a good job of holding an offside line. He wasn't offside, so you got to track and get back in. And here's a good look at it. Good first touch there. But Timmer does very well to let Ben Morris sit. It wasn't going to be easy. Goes off of Ben Morris, goal kick. I love that kind of defending, Rob.
What makes Jared Timmer so special? We joked about it in last broadcast. We don't say his name a lot because he's rarely in the picture because he's defended so well before the ball arrives to his opponent. And he's already got a nice mention from you. So he's up already.
That's a badge of honor if I've ever heard one.
Kecko all the way deep here. And with this formation, you'll see Roro and Kecko have a lot of room to operate. Lose chances for Luis Felipe to get back up, and see Sanchez and Jack Gurr play higher.
And that's because there's solidity in other areas, right? Arnold Lopez is going to stay right where he is. The back three is going to stay right where they are. Russell Cicerone does a nice job of staying in between the two center backs.
Meanwhile, Detroit looking for a big swing and opportunity there was Richard Ballard, denied again by Jared Timmer. Played in again, holding, playing it forward, looking for Robinson this time. And it'll be Danny Vidiello to go to ground to snuff this out one more time. A ninth minute Luis Felipe goal from Russell Cicerone is the difference here a half hour in.
That's good from Detroit City. I feel like when they play with a little bit more urgency, even in other games that they've participated in this season, it's not when they need to bypass the midfield, but when they just play one or two touch, get the ball off their feet and really try to play on the front foot and dictate the action. I like that version of Detroit City. When they sit back and have to react instead of being anticipatory, that version isn't doing very well. They don't seem as connected, don't seem as organized. But when they put those sequences together, it's good. And they're in that attacking third in a meaningful way, but now they just got to get that last touch to score.
Gurt, cross, Sanchez looking to get there and headed away by Jalen Robinson, another deep throw.
Yeah, great defending there from Jalen Robinson. It's not easy to do that back post defending. You got to stay disciplined. You got to know where everybody is at all times. You have to have your head on a swivel, as my old coach Bob Gansler, the 1990 U.S. World Cup coach, used to say to me back in the day. And Jalen Robinson did that to perfection.
For Cicerone in space, Steinwasher will come out. Flag was up offside for number 11. Republic coming off a big win against Colorado Springs, 4-0. Russell, Dami, Luis, Luther, all with goals. And what a time was just a 1-point separation between the two clubs. Colorado Springs winning tonight, beating New Mexico United 2-1. Monterey Bay taking down Indy 11, 3-2. And in the East Coast, Lewis City and Charleston, a scoreless draw. Cicerone picking up what was left for him. Roro is going to play this out to space to Gurr again. Rinse and repeat, Jimmy. Couple of Republics down in the box. Sacramento hoping for a foul, maybe more. And they'll at least get the throw here, but again, multiple Republic players making a run, making it difficult for Detroit City. Rodrigo Lopez curling this ball in, and easy enough for Michael Bryant.
Sometimes those passes might feel hopeful for the fans or hopeful for the guys that are playing, but I think they're really important when you see Rodrigo Lopez, Roro, just whipping it into the box in a dangerous area, it still puts the defense on high alert. They have to be on their toes. They can't relax. And obviously, when you have a striker like Russell Cicerone in there, who's very active, who's very alert, I can't tell you, when you're on that side of it, when you're trying to defend, you're like, man, these guys just feel relentless. There's nothing that we're doing to slow them down. So I'm very curious to see what Trevor James does, the manager of Detroit City, what kind of adjustments he makes in the second half to not only slow the Sac Republic attack down, but also to generate more of their attacks that actually makes Sac Republic suffer. I don't feel like we've actually seen them suffer too much this game.
As a defender, would you rather see a physical imposing striker, or is it more difficult to defend maybe three different players making constant runs?
Well,
neither
I could do both, Rob, just to throw that out there.
Back
I
was excellent. In your day.
Yeah, back in my day, I could handle anybody thrown my way. But I think it depends on how the team is set up. If you have a big physical striker up top.
And Jacker will receive yellow. Sorry, Jimmy, there for the challenge from behind.
No, I'm a big fan of a nice, firm yellow card from the referee. But if you have a big physical striker up top, and you have a team that whips balls in regularly, then yeah, that guy is going to be a little bit more of a problem than maybe a couple crafty guys that just play in front of you all the time. But here's a look here. Jack Gurr trying to get back into the play. Maybe feels a little momentum, just mistimes it. I say just, he mistimed it. Proper yellow card from Jack Gurr.
Out there, Sanchez. Look at that. He might be 20 years old, but I'll tell you what, Jimmy, there's a lot of veteran-like tendencies he already makes at such a young age.
It's incredible. Just his use of the body there, that understanding of not overcommitting, letting Connor Rutz make his decision on where that first touch is going to go, and then trying to go win it. That's not an easy skill, but he makes it look easy.
Gurr heading this one down. Kecko from Vidiello originally. Republic are now building, looking for Cicerone. Air mails it just a bit too much, but Sacramento still in possession. Lopez feeling the pressure, finding Sanchez. Back to Roro. Jack Gurr, little dummy. Could have been a run there by Kecko.
I think what everybody needs to take into consideration when they're watching this sequence is that even though the first cross by Kecko didn't work out, Sac Republic still has enough pressure that they're now dictating another attack, right? They're still being dangerous. They're still moving Detroit City from side to side. They're making them run. That's just going to get them more and more tired. That's going to open up space, maybe not now, but a little bit later, as those legs start to, and minds get a little bit more tired from Detroit City's perspective. When Detroit City right now is having an attack, it's just one attack. They don't have that follow-up. They're not, as I said before, not making Sac Republic suffer. They need to figure out a way to continue to push them back. And I think Sac Republic's doing that with real class tonight.
Sweet. Find Lopez, Cicerone, out wide again right. This time it's Kecko, Gurr central. Driven ball well. Here's Rodrigo Lopez trying for the header. Chance for Gurr, and it just wasn't enough. Tried to go for the bicycle there, but Steinwasher saw that one, just dribbled towards his way, and Jacker, one of the athletic players on this team that is just impressive night after night.
I
that
think Jacker's eyes just got so big. Visions of grandeur. He was already going to celebrate in the corner, just couldn't time it right, but I appreciate his ambition, Rob.
Out left, Detroit City, cross coming, but Shane Wheat covering well.
This is a really important next 5 to 10 minutes of the game, especially for Sac Republic. Can they get into half with the 1-0 lead and make the adjustments they need to see out this game? And for Detroit City, can they find that goal, right? So there's a lot riding on this. And it's not, this isn't about talent or skill, Rob. This is about focus and a desire to make plays when that moment arises. And right now, Sac Republic's doing more of that than Detroit City.
Injury watching this Republic team, when you talk about focus, it's the one thing these guys get on each other for, is just making sure that they're clinical in everything that they do, and they're hard on each other. They have a lot of fun together, very close-knit group, but they expect perfection from each other, and I think that's why you're having the success early on in the season.
Another thing we just witnessed there, Rob, which I love from Sac Republic in particular, is that when they win the ball, and there was a bad giveaway there from Amumensa from Detroit City, when they look to transition, that first pass is to go forward. It's to break the lines. That doesn't allow Detroit City to swarm the ball, to actually get set up and put that pressure there. And Sac Republic is excellent at this season. And if there's a stat for that, I'm sure they got to be one of the best at in transition. That first pass always goes forward. And when they look for that, it's so, so dangerous. They have to continue to do that to get this victory tonight.
Well, that's something Mark Briggs has been screaming about since the first day he was hired, is not going backwards. It's making a forward pass, get into the attack, try to spring something forward. And it's taken a while maybe to fully implement. But you're right, here in this campaign, it is fully on display and showing the worth, as this goal differential now plus 12 on the year, having allowed just one goal on the season. And it takes pressure off your defense, right? Any mistake is probably not as critical. Expect when it's going backward. Here's Jalen Robinson, and the flag is up.
A good discipline there from Sac Republic to hold that line, not drop too deep, just to drop. And this is a good moment in time in the game to drop, because, oh, whatever, 5 minutes left, they're in front of us, it's not a big deal. But I like that they're taking pride in making sure that they don't just drop to drop. Now, with regard to Detroit City, I think they're trying to maybe do too much, trying to find that home run pass, I like to say, without maybe bringing some in. They got to suck Arnold Lopez out of those positions, right? They want to create those passing lanes. They're having trouble getting into those spots. And I think if they can commit one of the center backs from Sacramento, if they can commit Arnold Lopez to maybe get out wider into the sideline channels or closer to the sideline, that's going to lend itself to success. But they've just been trouble finding that one connective tissue pass right in front of that back for them from Detroit City. I mean, they've got some questions, and we'll see if they've got some answers at halftime, because right now I got more questions than answers.
And we talk, you know, so cavalier at times just about identity and how Republic had been able to form one over the last couple of years. And over last year, we saw what that translated to in the Open Cup run. We're seeing here in this season, as Jalen Robinson not playing that as cleanly as probably he would like. And now there, Sanchez was just waiting for that mistake. And now it'll be Timmer who will send this to Danny Vidiello. We talk about identity, and it seems that Detroit maybe doesn't have that identity that they're hoping to build quite yet, and that ultimately has an impact on results.
No question. Again, I'll go back. This is the seventh game that Detroit City has played. They've only played the same lineup twice in back-to-back games. Due to injury, due to form, due to suspension, and I think that lends itself to a lack of consistency. Who's playing where and when? You've got maybe a couple guys playing out of position. They're going to find their way. Again, I'm a huge fan of Trevor James, and obviously they had the experience of being in the USL Championship for the first time last year and making the playoffs. So they can lean on that. But sometimes when you have some turnover in the offseason, it just takes you a few games to find your feet. And we'll see if they can kind of weather the storm. This is their third consecutive away game, so we'll see how it looks when they go home. And maybe they get a boost by beating Minnesota United in the Open Cup.
That ball from Gurr looking for Sanchez. And you're right, a lot of momentum can be built off an Open Cup if you're able to get a couple of games, and it builds that confidence that can be translated to the championship. Right side here for Ballard out of Louisville, Kentucky. To the right side it'll go. This one is just in the reach of Danny Vidiello. Outstretched, showing some athletic ability there. Those ones make you a little nervous. You're a coach, Jimmy.
Yeah, 100%. Ballard does a very nice job of getting the ball out wide. Good hold-up play there from Simonson. And when he gets here, I think he realizes and recognizes properly he's in a 1v1. Why not go at him? It's the attacking third. You're going to put Wheat under a lot of pressure. I think Ballard lets Vitiello and Sac Republic off the hook by lofting that in. I think you got to go hard and low. Maybe you get an own goal like they had against El Paso. So he might want that one back, but it's a sign of intent. And so I think that's something that Mark Briggs is going to have to figure out in terms of how do we slow down Ballard if he gets isolated 1v1.
It'll be 2 minutes of stoppage time here in Sacramento. Luis Felipe in the ninth minute. We're coming up at the break. We're going to sit down and have a little chat with Jimmy Conrad.
Oh, no.
Surprise questions galore.
I love it.
Yeah, we'll talk about sort of what Jimmy's up to these days, a little bit of the state of you.